I'm Guleen ma'am, your mathematics teacher from DPS Lamachore. In our previous lecture, we have completed chapter number 12, part 3 and discussed pie chart worksheets. Today, we are going to start part 4 and we'll discuss bar graph worksheets. So, let's begin. So, let us start with worksheets or bar graph. Question number 1 is observe the bar graph given below and answer the questions. So here you can see bar graph. On the basis of this, we have to answer the questions. So the title of the bar graph is Serial Production in the Shopping Mart in May 2018. So now A bar, which cereal costs less? By seeing the bar graph, which cereal costs less? Maize. So right here, M-A-I-Z-E. B bar, name the cereal that costs rupees 20 per kg. Which cereal costs rupees 20 per kg? Barley. So right here, B-E-R-L-E-Y. Now C bar, which is the costliest cereal? And what is its price difference with the second most costliest cereal? So here by seeing the bar graph, the costliest cereal is rice. So right here, rice. And what is its cost? It is lying between 44 and 42. So it is rupees 43. So right here, rupees 43. Now D bar, find the difference in the cost per kg of ragi and wheat. So what is the cost of ragi? Rupees 28. So right here, rupees 28. Minus, what is the cost of wheat? Rupees 18. So the difference is rupees 10. The difference in the cost per kg of ragi and wheat is rupees 10. E bar, how much is the total cost of barley and maize per kg? So by seeing the bar graph, what is the cost of barley? Rupees 20. So right here, rupees 20 plus what is the cost of maize? Rupees 15. So right here, rupees 15. If you add, it is rupees 35. So the total cost of barley and maize is rupees 35. Question number 2. So this bar graph shows the favorite breakfast items of the students of class 5. So answer the following questions. A bar, which is the favorite breakfast item? So by seeing the bar graph, the favorite breakfast item is sandwich. So right here, sandwich. And how many number of students like sandwich? 25. B bar, which is the least popular breakfast item? So the least popular breakfast item is cornflakes and milk. So right here, cornflakes and milk. And how many number of students like cornflakes and milk? Only 10. C bar, how many students like toast and butter? So 15 students like toast and butter. So right here, 15 students. Now D bar, which two breakfast items are equally liked by the students? So paratha and boiled egg. Right here, paratha and boiled egg are equally liked by the students. How many number of students like? 20. Next, how many students gave their choices? So total 90 students gave their choices. So right here, 90. So I hope students, now you are able to read the bar graph and answer the questions. Question number 3. So this bar graph shows number of men, women and children in a village. Answer the following questions. A bar, what is the scale of the graph? So here scale is given that 1 centimeter represents 50 people. So right here, 1 centimeter represents how many people? 50 people. As you can see in the bar graph that vertically spacing is 50, 100, 150, 200 and so on. Spacing is of 50 each. B bar, how many men are there in the village? So there are total 750 men in the village. So right here, 750. Now C bar, how many women are there in the village? So there are total 550 women in the village. So right here, 550. Now C part, how many children are there in the village? So how many children are there in the village? 200. So right here, 200. Now E part, what is the total population of the village? So for finding out total population of the village, we will add 750 plus 200 plus 550. So let us write here, total population of the village. So we will add here 750 plus 550 plus 200. So it is 1500. Total population of the village is 1500.
Question number 4. Look at the bar graph given below. So here you can see the bar graph given. So these are the subjects written horizontal way and these are the marks written in a vertical way. So read it carefully and answer the following questions. Question number 1. What information does the bar graph give? So it shows the marks obtained by a student in 5 subjects. Second question, in which subject is the student very good? So in mathematics, we can see the student is very good as he scored 75 marks. How we came to know it is 75? It is lying between 70 and 80. Next question, in which subject is he poor? So he is poor in Hindi subject as he scored 40 marks in Hindi. Fourth question, what are the average of his marks? The average of his marks is 56.
Construction of bar graphs or column graphs. In brief, let us recall what is a bar graph. Bar graph is the simplest way to represent a data. Next point, it consists of rectangular bars of equal width. It consists of rectangular bars of the equal width. Now, the space between the two consecutive bars must be the same. Space between the two consecutive bars must be the same. Bars can be marked both vertically and horizontally, but normally we use vertical bars. The height of the bar represents the frequency of the corresponding observation. Now let us observe the following data for the bar graph. Question is, 150 students of class 5 have popular school subjects as given below. Draw the bar graph for the same. So now let us do this question through screen.
So before solving the example, let us discuss the steps in construction of bar graph or column graph. The first step is, on a graph, draw two lines perpendicular to each other intersecting at O. Second point, the horizontal line is x-axis and vertical line is y-axis. Third point, along the horizontal axis, choose the uniform width of bars and uniform gap between the bars and write the names of the data items whose values are to be marked. Next point, along the vertical axis, choose a suitable scale in order to determine the heights of the bars for the given values. So frequency is taken along y-axis. Keep in mind that frequency is taken along y-axis. Next point, calculate the heights of the bars according to the scale chosen and draw the bar. So in this example, take the subjects along x-axis and number of students along y-axis. So here you can see the capping I took of 10, 10, 10, 20, 30, 40. As maximum it will reach till 40. Number of students will be in y-axis and subjects will be in x-axis. So French is 30. So 30 is marked here. English is 20. It will be here. And maths is 26. 26 will lie between 20 and 30. Here it is 25. Just one above it is 26. Geography is 38, it will lie between 35 and 40. And science is 34, it will lie between 30 and 35. So this is the complete bar graph. Next question, the number of absentees in class 5 was recorded in a particular week. Represent this data on the bar graph. So here you can see the table, days are given from Monday to Saturday and number of absentees. So now let us draw the bar graph. So here, on y-axis, there will be number of absentees and on x-axis, days. So on Monday, there are 130 students absent. On Tuesday, 120 students were absent. On Wednesday, there were 135 students absent. On Thursday, 130 students. Friday, 150 students. And Saturday, 80 students were absent. So students, here I took the scale of 10-10 gap, 10, 20, 30 and so on till 160. Now, A part, on which day the maximum and minimum students were absent? So on Friday, maximum students were absent and on Saturday, 80 students were absent, that is minimum. B part, how many students were absent on Wednesday and Friday? So on Wednesday, 135 students were absent and on Friday, 150 students were absent. C part, on which days the same number of students were absent? So, on Monday and Thursday, same number of students were absent, that is 130. Next question. The following are the marks scored by Arun out of 50 in different subjects in an exam. Represent this information on a bar graph. So, in table you can see subjects written and marks scored. So, these are the marks scored by Arun out of 50 in different subjects in an exam. So now let us draw the bar graph. So here in x-axis there will be subjects and y-axis there will be marks obtained. So English 40. So here 40 is for English. Urdu is 30. Then maths is 50. Science is 45. So this 45 will lie between 40 and 50. History is 25. So 25 will lie between 20 and 30. So I hope students, now you are able to draw the bar graphs. So for drawing the bar graphs, you require graph paper, scale and pencil.
Now let us practice different questions on representing the bar graph from the following questions given. Question is, the number of bed sheets manufactured by a factory during 5 consecutive weeks is given below. So here you can see the table. Weeks is given 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th and 5th. And number of bed sheets. So in 1st week, how many bed sheets are given? 600. In the 2nd week, how many bed sheets are given? 850. 3rd week, it is given 700. 4th week, 300. And 5th week, 900. So now let us draw the bar graph. So here you can see the bar graph, it is y-axis and this is x-axis. Horizontally it is written weeks and vertically it is written number of bed sheets. And the scale we took of 100, as you can see 100, 200, 300 and so on till 900 and whenever it comes 850. So 850 is lie between 800 and 900. So I hope students, now we are able to draw the bar graphs. Students, that's all for today's class. I hope you all have understood Guleen ma'am's class. So chapter number 12, part 4, bar graph worksheets completed. Practice all these questions at home. Now we'll continue in our next class. Do like, share and subscribe my channel. Take care. Bye-bye.